In 2020, a novel virus, SARS-CoV-2, spread worldwide and caused a serious global pandemic. Many people died due to the infectious disease COVID-19 caused by SARS-CoV-2. In addition to developing vaccines, research on therapeutic drugs for COVID-19 is being conducted at a rapid pace. To realize drugs as soon as possible, diversion of existing drugs is a shortcut for this purpose. Main protease, Mpro, is an enzyme that cleaves polypeptides translated from RNA. In SARS-CoV, inhibition of Mpro controls viral replication. Since SARS-CoV-2 and SARS-CoV-Mpro have 96% sequence homology, it is expected that finding a way to inhibit Mpro will be effective for SARS-CoV-2 as well. However, it is still difficult to find effective drugs this way.
At the Center for the Computational Sciences, we are conducting their comprehensive drug discovery research using the multiple computational method to search for therapeutic agent for the COVID-19. At first, we performed a docking simulation of the crystal structure of the COVID-19 main protease obtained from the data server of Protein Data Bank.
Docking simulation is a method to determine whether or not a candidate drug binds to target protein by inserting a ligand molecule into the pocket of the target protein on a computer. Specifically, a ligand is first selected and the binding site of the protein is then determined as an input, and then the candidate substance is bound on the computer. Next, we perform MD simulations, which allow us to verify the correctness of the structure obtained from the docking simulations by analyzing the stability and also calculate an approximate binding free energy. For example, by modeling the bonding of lopinavir and ritonavir on Mpro, then by performing MD simulations, the top row shows the structural similarity to the initial structure. It is found that the structure is very stable at 200 nanosecond simulations. The second row shows how well the hydrogen bonds between the protein and the ligand are maintained. And the third row shows how well the ligand binding stability can be estimated by monitoring the number of atoms in contact between the ligand and the protein. These results show that ritonavir has more hydrogen bonds and atomic contacts, indicating a better binding ability than lopinavir. In contrast, we use quantum theoretical binding free energy analysis called fragment molecular orbital, FMO simulation, to precisely analyze ligand-protein interactions and to quantitatively evaluate candidate inhibitors and their binding modes. There are advantages and disadvantages to these three methods. Docking simulation is fast in computation time, but less accurate. MD simulation is intermediate in terms of computation time and accuracy, while FMO simulation is slower but more accurate. By using all three methods, we are able to maintain a balance between computational complexity and accuracy to search for better drug candidates. For example, we combine these multiple methods to propose a pharmacore that could be a drug candidate. Pharmacore is a method to propose new compounds by extracting the characteristics of each component of the ligand molecule. The results of calculating the interaction with high accuracy by the last FMO simulation will be utilized.
We have analyzed several potential drugs And also, we are collaborating with an experimental research group toward a therapeutic agent for the COVID-19. Our group is also developing a new simulation method to dock the ligand directly into the pocket of SARS-CoV-19 by using the MD simulation. However, in the field of drug discovery, there are many drugs that don't reach for the market for various reasons. In order to realize more reliable therapeutic agents, it is important to accumulate candidate search and highly accurate evaluation of the potential drugs by using our approach.
Computational simulations allow us to search for and evaluate such candidates faster and at a lower cost than experiments. In particular, supercomputers are useful for such calculations. We will continue to apply this method to a variety of natural products and existing drugs to help find better drugs for COVID-19.